Welcome to Major Pandemic's Bunker Bar. I always imagine the world's best bar is in a cold world bunker far beneath the ground. It has an exceptional wine list. It has an almost unlimited bar of literally any liquor you can think of. And that would be Major Pandemic's Bunker Bar. Welcome. Advisory warning. In order to secure the Bunker Bar, all firearms were loaded prior to the recording of this episode. Also, please note this episode contains facts and shit, which may be offensive to idiots and morons. Aha, you are a free trial subscriber, and you will hear a portion of this podcast. If you'd like to hear this podcast in its entirety, plus all the other podcasts, plus all the hundreds of content available on MajorPandemic.com, please become a paid subscriber. We've made it incredibly, insanely cheap and affordable for anyone. We have more great content coming, and in the interim, please enjoy this free sample. Welcome to this episode of Major Pandemic's Bunker Bar. Tonight, I've had just finished up a two-hour deep tissue massage at the Major Pandemic bunker here. I'm feeling great, having my flavored water to rehydrate after that, because you obviously, that's the right thing to do. You should be hydrating after a great massage, and I feel wonderful. My back feels great. The only thing would be better is if I went and saw the pandemic chiropractor, which I think is probably the next stop. So here at the Bunker Bar, one of the things that we often talk about during deep tissue massages is whether you should put a reflex sight on your handgun. So let's talk about that a little bit. The highs, the lows, and the recommendations on kind of my experience with this so-called upgrade. So the first caveat I'll say is, hey, I love red dots. They're fantastic. They are a wonderful, awesome upgrade to AR platforms, rifles, shotguns, some sort of large format AR, PCCs, all the above. And they're even a great addition, I think, on a hunting handgun with the right kind of application. For instance, my Glock 40, which is a 10 millimeter extra large gigantic Glockzilla 10 millimeter that has extra long slide. I do have a red dot on that, and it works fantastically, and I can connect all the way out to about 150 yards accurately with using that red dot. It works great, and it works actually a lot better than I would with iron sights with that Glock 40. So great example and huge pro for red dots on handguns. And I think that is the big selling point a lot of people will push, is you do get a lot more accuracy, or you can get, I would say, you can get a lot more accuracy with a red dot on a handgun. And some people who are practiced, such as competitive shooters, will also have shot time that is way faster with red dots than it would be with good old-fashioned iron sights. So that is the big selling point for red dots, is faster on target and higher accuracy. But my experience has been a little bit different. I can definitely give red dots a nod on the accuracy side on certain applications of handguns, notably more hunting handguns. I think those work out great. Definitely the rimfire side of handguns, yes, great application, and they do work out really well. Time on target, yeah, I would say that really depends on your skill level and amount of training that you've had with that gun and that red dot. I've seen people out of the holster, like they're crazy fast with a red dot. I personally don't think I could achieve that. Just because I am so hardcore ingrained with iron sights that I intentionally and instinctively look for the iron sights and then realize I'm looking at the back end of my red dot. mount. And so I kind of have to adjust the grip and find the dot and then take shot. Yes, I realize with practice and kind of modifying your grip slightly, you can bring that into line immediately. However, years and years and years and decades of shooting with iron sights, it's a little tough for me to overcome. I'm sure I'll get there eventually if the other caveats are satisfied. And let's kind of talk about those. The big pieces I see are mounting reliability, mechanical reliability, battery life, and weather resistance on reflex red dots. Now there's a couple of things I'll kind of caveat here that most of these don't really apply to normal tubed red dots, like an Aimpoint Micro, for example, or a EOTech, their standard EOTech series, or for instance, a Trigicon MRO, or one of their prismatic optics. And that's really because those are fully sealed tubes in both ends with the emitter in the middle, and usually approximately in the middle. And so that's sealed from the elements. Most of those that I named are very waterproof to a certain depth. And they're not just splash proof, they're weatherproof. If you do get mud on them, you just need to clean one side or the other end of the lens, and you're good to go. And there's a good chance that the weather has not affected those tubes. The other thing with those tube style emitters is they are a lot more durable. There's a lot more ability to, from an engineering perspective, isolate that emitter from shock. That has a big plus. And then up until recently, more recently in the last few years where we ended up with 50,000 hour reflex sights, generally those sealed emitter tube style sights tended to have, EOTech is an exception, tended to have very, very long run times and could hold a more substantial battery, did tend to be a lot more efficient. Now, that's kind of changed a little bit since we've got runtime on life, but there's a couple things I'll kind of point out. And mechanically, from a mounting perspective, usually those had pretty solid mount. There's a lot of beef to mount to from a mount perspective onto those tube style emitters or something like an EOTech or Trigicon and so forth. On their like their MRO as an example. So mechanically they could be mounted pretty well. So some of the disadvantages that a reflex sight has, which are the ability to mechanically mount very, very solid, the ability to isolate the electronics from shock, and the ability to waterproof, those big three pieces really are managed a lot better from an engineering design perspective in a tube-based red dot. Now, if we look at the current crop of reflex sights, there's a couple challenges. Thank you for joining this free sample of the podcast. I hope you enjoyed at least this 5-minute sample. And you know, keep in mind, for paid subscribers, you're also getting access to Becky Bunker, the AI-assisted reloading database and app, which is worth its price of entry there. Obviously, hundreds of articles, ongoing podcasts, full length, and everything else. I have made this insanely cheap at about $30 a year. So hopefully you see value, and we will see you here at the bunker.
This is Becky Bunker. If you are not a full paid subscriber to MajorPandemic.com, then you are definitely missing out on full access to hundreds of articles and in-depth reviews, plus exclusive content like my Becky Bunker generative AI-powered reloading calculator and database, and amazing full-length podcasts. We have made subscriptions super cheap, so go ahead and join now. Otherwise, Major Pandemic wants to start a members-only page of him, and no one wants to see that.